Hey, hi. So today I'm going to talk about PDM. It's something I wanted to talk about for a while now, but I never really got around to actually making a full video just about PDM because, I've had other ideas that I think are better, and I've never really been good at commentary. That makes making a video like this very difficult. Also, yeah, I'm under a really good alt right now. No one will ever suspect that it's me. Anyways, let's talk about PDM. So, PDM, why do I play PDM so much? Why have so many of my recent videos been about PDM when I obviously hate the mode? And that's because there is a good thing about PDM, and that's the fast attacks and the playing. It's a fast game with lots of combat all the time. The rounds are short, and there's much more combat than team mode. It's also a good mode by itself. I play for the combat, I play it for the fast play. Actually, that's about it. I only play it because it's a fast game mode. We have lots of combat. That's why I'm really into the idea of Rumble, because in Rumble, it's constant combat. Oh, look at these guys. Are they teaming? I think they're teaming. Okay. That's not one of the reasons I hate PDM. There's always going to be teamers, cross teamers, teamers in survival mode. People who team, they just team. There's not much you can do about that. But I do hate PDM for one thing and one thing only. The leaderboard. Oh my gosh, how many people are in this team? I can only see two people on the map and both of them are teamed. So this is gonna be an issue. At least it'll give me time to get to the point I'm trying to make, which is that even though PDM is a fun mode with super fast play and all that, it's still extremely frustrating because of how the leaderboard works. Basically, if you start out with a brand new ECP you've never played, and if you're decently skilled, you understand the mode, you can get up to maybe the 50th place real easy. Even if you lose a game by a few points, you're still going to be getting points. Okay, here's someone. This is not going to go well. So even though you're not very good, you could still level up quickly. You could get to the leaderboard, which is 100 players. But then once you pass the top 25, now we're getting into real sweaty territory. Players are absurdly good, and this mode will absolutely wreck you if you lose a game. The leaderboard is absolutely ruthless. It has no ruths at all. It's not gonna say sorry, it's not gonna be nice. It's gonna take 30 points off of your game if you lose by 1 point. And that's just absurd. It does keep good players on their toes, but I want to play this mode without being completely stressed about losing a single game and dropping 5 places on the leaderboard. Okay, this map is just full teamers. Next time I die, I'm just gonna join a team mode game. PDM is skill-based, and there's also a luck factor. So even if you play perfectly, there's still a chance you could lose a game. And of course, in any game, you want that. You want that sense of chaos, because I mean, a game would get boring if you win all the time, right? But the consequence for losing a game is just absurd. It's absurd. It's completely outrageous. No one should lose so many points just because. Oh, frick. He got the kill. That's very mean. So I used to hate PDM because of the kill stealers. But over the break I took from Star Blast, I was playing a lot of Minecraft. And in Minecraft, there's this game called Sky Wars. So in Sky Wars, you steal kills. I used to get really frustrated at Sky Wars, but then I just kinda understood the game. And it's still a fun mode. In Sky Wars, it's not like there's a leaderboard which makes you super nervous to just play the game. I wanna just play the game, you know? Have fun with the game. I think I can get this guy now. Yeah. Okay. Please be my target. Nope. Okay, and then now you, who's just been hanging around. My tracking is so good, guys. It's the EU servers. Oh wait, I think I can get this guy, actually. Yep, cool. All right, this is a lost game if I die to this guy. I only have a few gems. I'm not even gonna try to dodge, it's not worth it. Bye. Oh wait, that wasn't him. Wait, I have a chance. Oh, I don't. See, look, I was ranked 63 on the leaderboard. I gained 11 points from losing. But if you are in the top 25 and you lose a game by that margin again, you're going to be totally crushed. You're going to lose 11 points instead of gain 11 points.
Jello, if you've been complaining about the leaderboard this whole time, why don't you give us your idea for the leaderboard, huh?
Okay, yeah, let me tell you what I have in mind. My idea is you gain the number of points that you gain in-game. If Vinmana, well, however you pronounce that, suddenly got 4 times the points and won the game, I wouldn't lose points, but I would get 11 points instead. So suddenly it's not about winning, because winning doesn't matter and losing doesn't matter. You just have to get as many points as you can. And there could be 2 leaderboards in my mind. You could have a leaderboard for points, total points, and a leaderboard for number of wins. And this leaderboard would be reset, actually, after every month, after every ACW, maybe every quarter of the year, I don't know. That's the best idea I've come up with so far. Oh crap, dang it. Dang schnabbits. So I think that's a pretty decent idea. You don't lose points for losing. You get to play as much as you want. And it's still highly competitive. But instead of trying to win every single game and having to log out when you're scared about losing, instead, you're just trying to play as much as possible. 2 leaderboards, 1 for total points, 1 for total wins, and then it's reset, because it's all ranked, right? It's not like there's a casual PDM mode. Everything you do is linked to the leaderboard if you have an ECP. Did that shot hit that guy? What the heck? That's kind of neat. So I think that just by itself would make PDM significantly more enjoyable. So even if I were to lose this game right here, I'd still gain 9 points. Oh no, please, please die, please die. Dang it. Oh, I knew I shouldn't have taken that shot. Ooh, that was a nice shot by Daryl. Ooh, this is gonna be really close. I just need one more kill. Okay, this looks like a good kill. There we go. Nice, we won. And we gained 10 points. So Daryl here, who lost, would not go lose points. He would get 11 points, but he just wouldn't be leveling up as fast as me. So there is a point to winning. And there is a point to that winning leaderboard as well. Now, I really hope the devs consider this, because I know there's some algorithm which determines the number of points you have based on who you're fighting against in the game and all their ECPs and everything and their rank, total stuff like that. I don't know how much easier it would be to code, but there's certainly no algorithm which would determine how many points you get for a specific match. All right, I'm just gonna wait for you. There we go. And then that leaderboard is reset. And the reset is important. I used to play a game called Crunker. Their leaderboard never reset. So there are just people who've been playing for 2 years in the game, and they just have 1 million points, and there's no hope of anyone else catching up to them within the next 5 years. So having the leaderboard be reset for a certain amount of time, I think that's really important to keep people coming back to the mode, because you can get bored really quickly if there's no point to the leaderboard. Let the leaderboard reset, and then it's a race to see how many points people can gain within the certain amount of time. I would guess a month. You know, maybe it correlates with the ACW. Let me know what you guys think about it. I'm sure there are some flaws I've overlooked. Maybe you guys just have an idea that's better. I can always suggest changes, because I have YouTube rank, and that makes me important. Ooh, I got a kill. Dang, those O defenders are real tough. I even said in my video they're underrated, and yes, they are. O defenders are very underrated. Ooh! Dang it, dang it, dang it. Someone went in early and I wasn't expecting that. Okay. One more. Yeah, I used to hate PDM because I was just too salty and I didn't know how to win. But now, I can actually win a game. So thank you guys so much for listening. I know it's been quite the ramble I've gone on, so I really do appreciate that you've made it this far. I heard that if I tell you to like and subscribe, that will actually make you do it. So, like and subscribe. I never thought I'd be saying that, but I might even edit that out, actually. Okay, bye.